Welcome, ladles and jelly spoons, to King's Bishop Teaches Chess. I'm Coach Daniel, your host, also known as King's Bishop, here at chess.com, and I'm bringing another edition of the Tactics Training video series, the program where we start here at 1800 and we work our way up to the next 100 point level. And so let's get started with Tactics 1800. All right, as always, we identify the king, the queen, and anything that's undefended, like these two pawns in the center and this B man. We also identify threats like this threat against our queen. And then that helps us find our move, like queen to G5, threatening the magic square mate, and also getting in line with our opponent's queen. So if he plays G3, we take the pawn and win the queen with a discovered attack. So queen G5, and he gives up the queen since he would lose it anyway on the next turn. King, queen, queen, and he is attacking our bishop. We have an undefended rook, and our knight can attack this undefended pawn with check. And since it's check, he's got a move, then we take the bishop with an attack on the queen, and then we take the rook, winning a rook for the knight. Next one. Okay. The king, undefended, is attacking our knight. He's attacking our pawn. We'd love to promote, but then he'd give us check with his bishop. This bishop's undefended. So what we do is we give check, draw the king to h8, give check, forking the king and the bishop, and then we can defend our knight. So check, check, and check with the queen, and we're also defending the knight. Next one. All right, he's taken our bishop with his queen. There's the king, queen, undefended. He wants to promote and make a new queen. So in other words, if we take, he promotes. But then we can give check here on f7 and then get his rook, because it's g7 and 8 are cut off. So we'll win this rook after he takes our knight. So take, check, and okay, and checkmate in the next turn, because rook f8, queen takes f8. King, undefended. We can't take this pawn, because notice the seventh is under control from his rook, so that would be checkmate with rook b8. We'd love to push our pawn, but same thing, checkmate with rook b8. So we have to give our opponent check. So rook takes with check, king takes, then knight to e4 check. And if he moves back, if our knight's here and his king's here, he moves back, we fork the king and the rook. Or here and here, if he moves down, we fork the king and the rook. Or our knight here, king here, if he moves to h4, we give check protected by our knight and then fork the king and the rook. So that's got to be it. So capture, check, 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 and fork, and capture, and get out of check. All right. All right, king, queen, undefended. Well, this is pretty straightforward. What we're going to do is push the king over with a check and then run his two royal pieces through with our rook. Boom, and we win a queen for a rook. Next puzzle. All right, our rook's under a threat. There's the king, there's the queen, undefended. What we want to do here is attack the queen with our rook, which threatens queen to h3. Notice the queen cuts off the royal squares, so that would be checkmate, which means that after rook takes, he has to block with his rook. Rook takes, and now we just capture the queen. Next. All right, king, undefended. Actually, g3 is defended by the rook. Notice the king is cut off by our knight, and we can play rook b8, rook b6, checkmate. So once we play rook b8, he'd have to play knight d7 to stop rook b6, but then we play rook b7 and attack his knight and chase it away. Well, he can't run away. Yeah, he has to take away the defender of a5 and lose his rook. All right, king, queen, undefended knight. We could take that knight. The rook's also undefended. If we take the knight, he takes our pawn with check. So let's take advantage of this piece relationship and attack with bishop g7. He would have to take our bishop, removing the defender from his own bishop, which we capture with check. And whether he goes to c2 or c4, queen takes knight check. And actually, if he goes to c4, we can get a checkmate. These are only safe squares, so we capture the bishop and then play queen c4 checkmate. Is that right? I think it's got to be a queen, a bishop to g7, queen takes. Okay. He made it easy on us. All right, king, queen, undefended bishop. We want to take advantage. Our queen's under danger, so we need to get our queen out of danger anyway. Notice that this pawn cuts off g1. Our bishops are both aiming in the direction of his king. So if we can clear the pawn out, we play queen h3, getting rid of this pawn, so we can give a checkmate sequence. He takes king bishop to e4 check, king h2, and then bishop e4 check. Okay. And now, okay. Okay, checkmate finally. All right, king, queen. These pawns are undefended. The bishop's undefended. We take the pawn with check. We take the pawn with check. He blocks. We take the other pawn with check. So, okay, check. Check. Now the problem here is notice what we have. We have a minor for a minor, a queen for a queen, a rook for a rook, and he's got an extra rook here. So this is one of those ones where we just go for the perpetual. So queen. Now we got to be careful here. We have to play down here to h3 to stay on this diagonal. If you play to h5, king g8, and you have no way to capture the pawn or to play queen f7 because both of those are hot. So you have to stay on this diagonal and just go back and forth with your checks and bada bing, bada boom. King, queen. He's threatening checkmate with bishop g6, king g8, queen h7, checkmate. So we play bishop to g4, attacking the queen. Bishop g4, and then he can't play bishop g6 because bishop takes queen. So bishop g4, he could play queen h4, renewing the threat. But our bishop is out of the way, so our other bishop can play to e7 and attack the queen. All right, so that's got to be it. Attack the queen. Okay, we have check. Just take the queen and give him our queen. All right, he didn't make us go that far. King, no queen, undefended rook. Nothing else is undefended. We'd love to push the pawn, but it can't go anywhere. So instead, notice that the pawn covers these light squares. The king covers the dark squares. We have this big wall. And if we can get our rook to h1, it's checkmate. So rook h8. He runs away. He wants to go to b2. But that's okay. We'll trade rooks and then push our pawn, defend with our king, and we're going to promote on the next turn. King, queen, undefended. Well, actually, we have a magic square checkmate right here. Notice that his knight on c6 is pinned and does not defend, and our own knight does. So, checkmate, baby. All right. His rook's attacking our queen. There's the king, the queen. His other rook is attacking our rook, which means if we were to play... If we were to play queen takes rook, rook takes rook is check, king g8, the queen comes down and we're being mated soon. So, we can't play queen takes rook. Instead, rook takes rook, rook takes queen, rook takes pawn check, king to g1, and then our knight comes to f3 with check, forcing the king to h1, and then we're going to get the steamroller going. So check, check, check with this rook, capture. He has to give up his queen because it's the only legal move. We don't have to go any further. King, queen, undefended. All right, notice our bishop is in line with his king. So we have a discovered check. We give double check, check from the bishop, check from the rook. King has to go to g2 because it's double check. So then king, rook to h2 check. King to f1. And there's no continuation there. So instead, we take advantage of the relationship between our bishop and his queen by giving this discovered check. Rook takes pawn. And then rook to g2 is another discovered attack on his queen, threatening checkmate with the rook on h2, so we win the queen. The bishop defends, so check with the rook, with the bishop, rook to e2. He has to take it, bishop takes. He has to take it because rook to h2 would have been checkmate supported by the bishop, and that puts us at 1901. That was pretty fast. We did that in record time, it feels like. No mistakes this week, so that makes me pretty happy, and we're well underway. Next week, or in the next couple days, hopefully, tactics training 1900, and we'll take it up to 2000. Until then, I hope you learned something, and I hope you'll have a great day and play some great chess. Bye now.